Let's go back to the display message method that we were looking at earlier. We were trying to figure out what exactly is going on in here. From what we've learned so far, it looks like there's a text view object, and the variable name is called order summary text view. Then it says a bunch of code that we don't really recognize. But on the next line, we use that variable order summary text view, and we try to set the text on it to be this message. Let's find out more about how to call methods like this on objects. When we call a method on an object, it has to follow this format. First, we write the object variable name. In this case, it's title text view. Then we add a dot. Then it's followed by the method name, which is setText in this case. This method is defined exactly this way in the TextView Java class. The method declaration also specifies that there's an input parameter of a string. So we put parentheses and then pass in a string as input. Then we end the statement with a semicolon. When you write this line of code, it modifies the title text view object so that it displays this on the screen. The reason we use the object variable name here is because there could be multiple text views in your app. So make sure you're calling the method on the right object instance. When you're specifying input arguments, make sure you're specifying the right arguments in the right order according to the method declaration. So if there's no inputs, you would just have an empty set of parentheses. The way we pass inputs to a method is the same as we learned earlier in lesson 3. And remember to separate the object variable name and the method name with this dot. Here's another example. On that same title text view object, we're going to call the setTextSize method on it. This method takes an integer as input for the new text size. So in this case, we just pass 18 as the new text size. When the Android device executes this line of code, it's going to change this title text view to have a larger font size of 18. In this example, we're calling a method on the text view object that is called warningTextView. The method is called setTextColor, and it takes as input a new color. Notice that the color is specified as color.red. So if we look at the documentation for the color class, then we can scroll down and see that red is defined here. There are a bunch of other colors that you can use here as well. So when you call setTextColor, you could call color.blue or color.black. And lastly, here's an example of calling a method on an image view. This image view object has a variable name of welcomeImageView, and we call the method setImageResource on it. This method takes as input the new image that we should set on this image view. We specify the new image as a resource ID in the format of r.drawable. And this is the file name. This is just another use case of using resource IDs in Java code. To get the full list of methods that you can call on a text view object, just open up the text view Android documentation page. I can get to it by just searching for text view Android, then clicking here. So this is a page we already recognize, and we already know about the XML attributes that are listed on this page. If I scroll down further, then I can see a list of all the public methods in the TextView class. If you want to find something, you can just use Command F or Control F if you're on Windows. I'm going to look for the setTextColor method, which we used earlier. Here's the setTextColor method, and it takes an integer color as an input param. All these methods were declared as public methods in the TextView class. That's why we can call these methods now. If they were declared as private methods, we wouldn't see them show up here. When you're calling these methods, make sure you're checking what input parameters it requires, and you're passing in the inputs in the correct order and of the correct data type. When you're looking at code, sometimes you might not see the dot notation when calling methods. The difference matters whether you're inside a class or outside of a class. Let's look at an example within the TextView class. We have the setText method defined, as well as some other method. Say that you want to call the setText method from this other method. You can do so by calling setText and then passing in the input param. But where's the dot and where's the object variable name? Well, this line of code is actually short for this.setText_hello. This refers to the current object instance, and then setText is being called on this object. This is a format we're more familiar with for calling methods on objects. However, the this dot part is implied, and it's optional. So to make our code more concise, we can just call setTextHello. So notice the difference between calling setText within the class and calling setText outside of that class. When you think about it, this makes more sense because it's very clear which text view you want to set the text on in case you have multiple text views within this class. Here's another difference between being inside the text view class versus being outside the text view class. Within the text view class, you can access private variables and private methods. If you're outside of the text view class, you can't use methods that are private and you can't access private variables. Within the main activity class, you can only access public methods and public variables from the text view class.